John Lewis.
He in Congress now. Come out of Georgia with that. What he did was, they started a march from Montgomery. It was 600 children, old folks, and they had no weapons. And they attempted to go across the bridge to see the governor, Governor George C. Wiley, back then in 65. They met something. They met what you would call confusion on the bridge. Here you see the state trooper heavily armed with gas masks, horses, and it was a posse. What happened is that they go crawl. Now all they wanted was asking two questions in America in 65. March the 7th, 65. On the bridge. The only two questions that was asked were the right to be human and the right to vote. And that was what they were marching for. And they met on this bridge, they had a melee. State troopers come in knocking and riding over people on horses. Then they come through with tear gas. Nonviolent, children, all mixed was in there. So they were turned back. They came back together and finally made the march. This summer, every kind of movie star and all kind of politician was in that march. So they made it probably in. But this was a part, and like that bombing over there of 16th Street was a part of history that the world saw, and it didn't look good. Got a wind and come through here. It's been here 30 years, all this 30 years, and they won't preserve it. Now this is the history that you will not find, and what this is how the Africa put together that he had, because he had a knowledge of where he came from and could tell a story. I'm telling a story now. And the story is this. All the way back where life began and where we at today, people have breathed free air and had a free will to do right. Now what I mean by right, this one right, 65. Look at all them years before 65 and think about the treatment of the African. I'm talking about lynching. I'm talking about skinning people up just like a deer. I'm talking about castration. Every ill will and hurt have been inflicted on us, and what has happened is we have turned on our own self to self-hate. We jammed off in these freeways, you know, you got freeways up on the top. Then you got this, all of us scattered out in the so-called ghetto, or whatever you call it, where we packed in the inner city. And it then came where opportunity was not there. I'm talking equal opportunity. The education wasn't there. We had children that didn't know what to do or how to do it. And we have been isolated since we've been here. A part of what you call a big confusion, ball of confusion, that nobody wants to come right and come to the table. America is supposed to be these three things: vote, produce, and live. We too busy to hate not to do anything. We have turned into each other and eating each other up just like we don't care no more. But let me tell you something. There's a generation always that figure I could do better and I'm gonna make a move. If you ever need a generation now at the end, this is in Revelation time here. Then you got Armageddon and there's tribulation. Sodom and Gomorrah, Babylon. Look at the struggle that had been put just on this bridge where the world saw it and the United States had to do something. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all except Africa. Why? Why is we hated and feared when the African heart is God, love, and peace? Why is it? The African blood flows through every human being it is. Why is it hate? Why is it hate? God painted everything after he did all this work in this sky, all the affirmative in the sky. Made all them atmospheres up there, and then he come down to the earth and just decorated the earth with all that you see.